In biography, you want the audience to really feel a human being with a beating heart that they got to know. Because we had access to the family and Clive and people that knew her, there were very personal stories that we could tell.
It was like they wanted to share what she meant to them. In particular, Pat Houston, Whitney's brother, Gary Houston, and Ricky Minor, who was incredible, and Clive Davis.
Whitney Houston was probably the greatest contemporary musical artist, female, of all time. She was the ultimate pop singer, the ultimate R&B singer, and that's why she stood out all those years.
She was a shooting star. Comes once in a lifetime, and I think that her voice was so pure that it connected worldwide.
All Whitney wanted to do was just sing and have people clap and enjoy. People forget what you say, what you do, but they never forget how you make them feel.
It all started with Clive Davis.
I auditioned Whitney at a club called Sweetwater in New York, the year 1983. She sang in a way that just sent chills up your spine.
I believe in you.
Clive was definitely a genius in his own right, but he brought out the genius. He saw the genius in her. He saw the gift that she had.
He called me vocally ambitious.
I had been told about her. And don't forget, Dionne Warwick is her cousin. Aretha Franklin was a fabulous family friend. Her mother, Sissy, had been their sweet inspirations all those years.
God gives you a gift, you gotta use it right.
When Clive talked about doing a film addressing her given talent, it was a no-brainer for me.
I went and had lunch with Clive, with Naomi and Dennis, and the stories that he can tell and the detail with which he can speak to things, that's a gold mine. And of course, there's Ricky Minor, who was her musical director and band leader for years.
Hey, Whit.
Get ready.
How's the voice?
Fine, Ricky, how's yours?
I've been working on something new to finish your show.
Mm-hmm.
But it's big.
Whitney Houston was my heart, my sister, and my best friend. We met when I was 22 and she was 18, and I helped to put a band together for her to do a showcase to try to get a record deal.
My conversations with Ricky Minor, I've got to say, were some of the most moving. You know, somebody who knew her so well as a musician and as a friend and as a person.
Have you seen all the greats?
I think the most important thing is that people see the true heart of Whitney.
I was working with people in my makeup team who had worked with her, or people in crew, in the film crew, because she was part of the film industry too, who had worked with her. And everyone had stories, and everyone wanted to share their stories.
I first met Whitney Houston in 2008. My mentor, Roxana Floyd, an amazing makeup artist, had done Whitney for 20 plus years.
Are we gonna sit?
Yeah. And towards the end of her career, she gracefully asked me to do Whitney Houston.
Janine knew what colors Whitney wore. You know, she had those colors still in her kit, Whitney's colors, that we could then put on Naomi.
Eyeshadows and different blushes that created looks that Roxana created for Whitney. She always had to have red lipstick on. So prior to me actually doing Whitney's makeup, I would hand her a bag of red lips, and she would pick one out for the day and apply it, give me a little snarky look in the mirror and like put it in her back pocket. And I just remember that because that was us. And I would chase her around to wipe the lip off. But it was just those little moments with Whitney that I would cherish.
Every time we worked on a project, everyone wanted her to sing live. Well, I know you pre-recorded it, but can you sing it live? And for The Preacher's Wife, they had it not only pre-recorded all, but then sing everything live again in Newark in the cold. And she was like, okay, sure, because she loved to sing. There were magical moments like that all the time with Whitney. I think all of us would love Whitney just to be remembered for her music and how much she gave when she performed.
I know that Whitney would be very, very proud that we're doing this project together, because she knows that it's coming from people that truly loved her. It will be right, and something that her legacy would be very proud of.
It was wonderful to relive those magical moments that all of us that got to work with her got to witness.
She saw it like no one else in history, and an unparalleled talent that really affected the world forever.